Hi! The grade of a magnet is an important attribute. The higher the grade, the stronger the magnet, and the more expensive. So being able to test a magnet's grade at home is desirable. Did you get what you paid for? In an earlier video, I showed how to get an indication of the grade by using a high-precision Gauss meter. However, not many have a lab-grade Gauss meter lying around. Lately, I've been wondering if a magnet's density could tell us something about its grade. Would be convenient, since a scale is more common in a home than a Gauss meter. But is there a connection between grade and density? And is it easy to weigh a magnet? Let's find out! Be careful with large neodymium magnets. Don't let them bite ya. If there is a connection between grade and density, I probably have to measure the density precisely. The largest band I've seen quoted for neodymium magnets is 7.3 to 7.7 grams per cubic centimeter on Wikipedia. Most sellers just say 7.5 grams per cubic centimeter, regardless of grade. But weighing a magnet precisely is surprisingly difficult. This isn't the weight of this magnet. So far, my most precise measurement has been on a bath scale using myself as a spacer between the scale and the magnet. I simply measure myself without and with the magnet 5 times, and the difference in the two average weights is the weight of the magnet, 13.3 kilograms. Now I need to calculate the precise volume of the magnet, taking the chamfered edges into account. Alright, the numbers add up to 7.53 grams per cubic centimeter plus minus 0.03 grams since the bath scale is limited to 100 grams increments. Not bad. We are within the quoted densities for a neodymium magnet. But I would prefer to measure the magnet's weight even more precisely in 1 gram increments without going bankrupt. Who other than me would need a consumer level scale capable of weighing 13 kilograms in 1 gram increments? The Germans, apparently. My brother gave me this kitchen scale for Christmas. Designed by a German company, it will measure up to 15 kilograms in 1 gram increments. Perfect. Thank you very much. Let's test from how far away the magnet will affect the measurement on this scale. Looks like around 30 centimeters, a foot. We see a negative number since the top plate is attracted to the magnet, lifted, like here. I will double that distance and use a 65 centimeters long spacer. This way, the magnet should not affect the scale noticeably. Still, I couldn't help but switch polarity while weighing the magnets, and I noticed something interesting. The magnet was heavier with the north pole facing down. Am I seeing the effect of the angle of the Earth's magnetic field? As I have shown in an earlier video, the field is almost vertical at my place in the Nordics. Makes sense if the magnet is attracted towards the magnetic pole underneath with the north pole facing down, showing as an increase in weight. And repelled with the south pole facing down, showing as a decrease in weight. The mass of the magnet is the same in both cases, but the scale is measuring weight, not mass. I was eager to see if the result was repeatable. I tried again with the poles marked and got the exact opposite result, with slightly different weights. Clearly, some other factors in my setup is affecting the weight more than any effect from the Earth's magnetic field. I think the magnet is still messing with the scale at this distance. Would be interesting to test the pole switch right on top of the Earth's magnetic pole, near the geographic North Pole, where the effect is the largest. It's just a tad cold up there. Anyway, the average of the polar switch measurements should even out the effect and give us the right weight. Around 13,390 grams, giving us 7.58 grams per cubic centimeter as the best estimate for the density of this great N45 magnet. Let's try another large N45 magnet and see if it has the exact same density using the same procedure. No, it does not have the exact same density. The difference is only 0.5%, though. Maybe grades other than N45 have a noticeably different density. With the test method established, it is time to test three magnets of the same size, but with different grades. A grade N45, N48, and the mighty N52. I will not bother you by showing all 30 measurements. Let's go straight to the results. Fascinating. The higher the grade, the higher the density. But you may have spotted the big issue. The first two measurements of the huge grade N45 magnets are not a match. At all. Giving it a second try, I tested the 370 by 20 mm magnets on another, smaller kitchen scale. 30 measurements later, I'm still seeing a higher density with higher grade. It is, however, time to admit the defeat. A scale cannot be used to measure the grade of a magnet. This is a tiny sample size, but it is obvious that the densities are very, very close. Too close to tell you anything about the actual grade of the magnet, especially using uncalibrated kitchen scales. And could it be that they are actually even closer in density, and I'm just measuring a stronger pull towards the scale from the stronger magnets? Gives me another idea. Could a scale be used to rank the strengths of similar sized magnets? Imagine we don't know the strengths of these three magnets and want to use a scale to rank them. A quick test on the scale shows promising results. To be clear, this is not the total pull force of the magnets. It is an odd combination of the weight of the magnet and its pull on the magnetic scale parts below the weighing plate, like the battery. Still, the magnet with the highest grade does show the highest reading on the scale. Let me refine the method using the experience from the density test. I will mark the center of the scale for consistent results and use a spacer for easier handling and less scratches on the plate. And, of course, switch between poles for higher precision. Ah, this takes some weight off my shoulders. While a scale may not give you an indication of the grade of a magnet, it may at least give you an indication of the strength of the magnet. If you are careful with the measurements, you can rank similar sized magnets from weakest to strongest. Also notice that perhaps you shouldn't worry too much about the grade. In a practical example like this, the difference between grade N45 and N52 is surprisingly small. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. If you want to help me keep going with the videos too, you can sign up on Patreon. For only $1 a month, you get full access to all posts. Link in the description. Thank you. If you want to watch more, I recommend the video where I measure the angle of the Earth's magnetic field using simple and high-tech solutions. Links in all the usual places. Don't forget to click like and subscribe for more discoveries. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.